Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. My name is Ace and I got another TF2 live commentary here for you as I'm playing as a sniper here on Badwater in the attacking side of things, of course, as you can see, as we are in blue, of course. Now, before I go into the actual commentary, not only will I switch my loadout just a tiny little bit because I think that at the beginning of a particular match, this loadout will be a little bit more helpful. You should also check out my links that I'll put in the description as I think some of you guys have missed my recent TF2 videos, including a scout video where I made a lot of mistakes and a heavy video. So make sure that you check that out if you haven't yet. Because, or it might also have been that YouTube has been borked again. It wouldn't surprise me. Because I don't think that they have been coming through properly. So this is just a notification that you may have missed it. And if you have, check them out and you should all be well. This match is about to start. Of course, I got a new spray as well. Look at that fanciness. And there you go. A couple of seconds left. I'm going to see if I can actually see one of the snipers or... Well, talking about snipers. We did laser dot coming in. It's fully charged. So I know he's going to be looking at the direct angle. He's going to be on that high ground, perhaps in the corner. As I said, it is indeed in that corner, as you can see. It's like just a matter of trajectoring and estimating. And as I do that, I take him out. Unfortunately, this opens me up for another sniper. And he does take my head clean off. But it's a one for one right now. I anticipated and I saw exactly where that high that sniper was. Because I know that if he's aiming right in this corner, knowing the entrance, and of course, he can only be at a few spots, courtesy of the actual angle, of course. So, if you know and understand mathematics, if you will, you can actually use that against the enemy like that. Unfortunately, if you don't see the enemy that might be on the other side, if you open yourself up to an opening like that, well, you know, you may lose your head. They have a lot of snipers though, which is good, because then it's just become a sniper battle, and in previous video I have proven that I'm pretty decent against other snipers, as long as I'm warmed up. Now this is my very first sniper video this week, I suppose, so warmed up is just a matter of opinion. So we'll see what this turns out to. Alright, nice headshot right there. I bumped into a spy or into the wall, not sure which one it was. Nonetheless, it's gonna be okay though. I, of course, have the Gerardis. Well, I haven't really used it yet. I'm going to sit back. I do see, of course, the fact that they have a sentry. So I'm just going to walk back and make sure that I can use my sniperness to my advantages. That long-range tastiness as I take this location for me. I'm not going to keep my pointer or my laser charged because they might be able to see it. If I'm going to charge it, I'm going to do it like that. Right there. Head clean off. This round starts off. Start off a little bit iffy. With a 1v1, but there you go, the headshots are coming out, the kills counter is leading up, and my usefulness as a sniper seems to be increasing. And I always like to be useful in a match, even if I don't make any kills, if as long as I'm useful, I feel okay about it. And that's always what the most important thing about, at least for me, is. Head throw my Gerardi, not sure if it actually hit anything, I don't believe it actually did. But that's okay though, because it recharges, unlike the caber, for example, for the demo man. Oh, another nice headshot, that demo is clearly weak right now. As you can see, he actually killed himself, so usefulness increasing. Is that a spy? Is that a spy? Well, not a spy, but just a spy. Another headshot coming out. He was overhealed by the looks of it. So I'm getting the headshot. They are not able to getting into... They're not turning into kills, though, which is also kind of annoying, because I'm getting headshots, but the headshot counter stays the same, depending on my kill counter. It only counts headshot kills, which is a little bit annoying. Another headshot, but he's overhealed. Another headshot. He, this time, did not have enough health. So headshots coming out left. Headshots coming out right. Do see a heavy right there with the brass beast. Alright, he wants to have a playtime. That's okay. He actually getting a random crit on me. Wow. That is the most luckiest of battles. I would have been able to survive that hit. I swung too soon, which was my bad. A stupid mistake. A rookie mistake. I swung too soon and he was able to land a hit on me. But that apparently was a random crit. Welcome to random crits, by the way, guys. Honestly, if I ever get my own TF2 server, if I ever become famous and rich, I suppose, I will turn off random crits as fast as I can say I will turn off random crits. Getting a nice headshot again. Trying to get that sniper. I see a lot of bullets flying around. And I see a rocket jumping soldier, which is okay. He's shooting rocket jumper rockets as if they are actual rockets. Getting a nice headshot on that demo. He's going to be forced back as he is weak. Trying to get another headshot on it. It's not going to be okay though. I'm a little bit scared as I'm open... Right there in the line of fire. Getting a nice headshot on that pyro. For a first match in a very long time for a sniper. I am getting headshots left and right on a Skyle server. And I'm always convinced that the Skyle server hitboxes for heads are a little bit lower, but right now I don't even believe that anymore. I am on fire. And if I would be ignited by a power right now, that would have been very punny, but there you go. I'm looking very good right now. My Pirelli Miracle Elixir is apparently giving me a lot of luck. And I like that. If you don't know where that is from, it's from a Sweeney Todd movie. That's a Johnny Depp movie called Sweeney Todd. Sweeney Todd, the demon on Barber Street? Something along those lines. Is that an actual spy? Looking good, though. Oh, hello. Bring out the Girardi. Finally getting the crit going properly. I will give you a shave, the closest that I ever gave. Missing a very easy headshot right there. But there you go. Cactus getting taken down on top of that. See the sentry gun going up. I take that down as well. I'm going to take the sniper position. Going to make sure that there is no sniper on the left side. On the right side, I do see the medic on the bottom there. But he's already on an angle that I cannot hit. Got a little bit scared there. I thought it was a spy, which I instinctively threw Girardi on. That's okay. I'm going to sit here and hopefully get a nice headshot going. Or just a body shot. Just do some fuel damage. That's okay as well. He now knows where I'm at, though. And he does have a medic on him. That's definitely a spy. Called it. It's a DR spy as well, as you heard. He decloaked almost immediately. There you go. He's going to go for it. I have a Girardi ready. He's going to use for the ambassador shot. I'm trying to dupe the shots. And actually, I should have switched to my sniper gun. To my sniper rifle. And just started shooting him. No point. If he pulls out his gun, he's not going to get close to you anyway. Also, that's one of the reasons why I like the SMG, because it's easier to spray them with it and force them back and, of course, twitch their aim, especially when you have the ambassador, to avoid headshots as well on top of that. Just something to note. But, coming out very strong, 9 kills, 3 deaths, a lot of headshots, so I'm kind of okay with that. My usefulness is, I feel, taking off, because I have to consider that dead angle in Badwater. I hate this part of Badwater to shoot at, if you will, especially because they will spam in that choke point, which means I can't stand there, which means I have to stand still right here on this top to have some kind of safety. But as you can see, that only gives me an opportunity, a small window to snipe at, and even then, so they can hit me as if it's nobody's business. Right. I do see the pipes coming out, as you can see, also the stickies, crit stickies, by the way. I'm just gonna take them out. Like I said, you can be useful without even killing. Just a matter of how you look at it, I suppose. Do see, of course, a sentry gun. The spy is looking for a sap, but I'm taking some damage. I'm going to go back, making sure that I'm full health, or at least pretend that I'm full health. Oh, almost got a headshot there on that soldier. All right, this is a DR spy, as you can see. He has Girardi on him. He's looking for a corner step or a trick step. Not having it, though. However, my bushwhacker has it for him, and getting out Cactus again, working on that sentry gun as it gets taken out there by a fellow sniper. As I do see the sticky spamming upward. Alright. Oh, there was a close call right there on that pyre, trying to save that demo. Not happening, though. I'm trying to do some twitch aiming, trying to avoid those pipes. Barely doing that. As once again, they can just keep spamming upward, and we can't really aim downward. Which is why I hate this particular spot on Badwater. Avoid all the damage right there. Gonna hopefully a lucky Girardi. Did hit several people there. Which may force them back. May scare them into retreating. Or actually allow my team to get some easier kills. Did not see the sticky trap. I die because of it. But as you can see, the kill feed actually gets some assists. Courtesy of the Frontier Justice Engineer. Thanks to my Girardi. And as you can see on our team comp, it's the reason why we can't really push up. We have several snipers, we have several engineers, and also several spies. Which, of course, doesn't really allow us to push forward quite effectively. Unless we get a nice streak of wonderful headshots, backstabs, which will give us a clear opening. But that usually doesn't really happen. Unless people are really doing some weird stuff. And as you can see, both snipers here are basically trying to snipe on the same position, which basically blocks vision, which means that sniper position is currently useless for me. Right, going to see if I can use my Girardi in a somewhat useful way. Alright, oh, miss a headshot on a heavy that was walking in a straight line. Our power classes, though, they are spawning, they are at the bomb. I'm gonna sit back, try to get that heavy weakened, or even out of the way. Looks like it isn't going to happen, though. The scattergun coming in from behind with a random crit. Even if it wasn't a random crit, he would have been able to kill me anyway. I did not expect that scout to be there, as we had several people pushing up strongly. So I guess nobody was there. I anticipated that completely wrong. I assumed wrong, and I paid the price for it. So there you go. However, they are able to push out quite nicely, as we are still working on that bomb. But will it be enough? I'm just going to sit back, hopefully avoid any scouts. Now, I do have a mini sentry with me here, so I feel a certain kind of immortality, as we are able to push up that bomb and, well, claim victory, as we are able to, well, as you can see, explode the last point. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to subscribe if you haven't, and I will certainly catch you guys next time. Take care.